section should give a short introduction to the AIS system, display of information, and available options. The Automatic Identification System, abbreviated AIS, is a transponder system designed for the exchange of information between ships and between ship and shore stations. Information may also be exchanged between ships and AIS-equipped aircrafts. Regulation 19, Safety of Life at Sea, SULAS, Chapter 5, requires AIS to be fitted on certain ships through a phased implementation period spanning from 1st of July 2002 to July 2008. In addition, specific vessel types, warships, ships operated by governments, etc., are not required to carry AIS. Also, small vessels, leisure craft, fishing vessels, etc., and certain other vessels are exempt from carrying AIS. Some waterways, such as the Panama Canal and the St. Lawrence Seaway, already require all ships operating in their waters to be equipped with AIS. Users of AIS should always bear in mind that information provided by AIS may not give a complete picture of the shipping traffic in their vicinity. There are many reasons why the AIS may not give a correct picture of the traffic, such as AIS malfunction, AIS switched off, no carriage requirement, etc. This is why AIS is not an equipment that is included as part of the collision regulations in other ways than by all means. AIS is intended to enhance safety of life at sea, safety and efficiency of navigation, and protection of the marine environment. The purpose of AIS is to help identify vessels, assist in target tracking, simplify information exchange, and provide additional information to boost situation awareness. The AIS is based on a technology called Self-Organized Time Division Multiple Access, or SOTDMA. Which allows for seamless operation worldwide. This concept basically utilizes known technologies, but combines them in a unique way. The AIS transponder broadcasts the data fully automatically to other ships within reach. The AIS transponder forms a cell where the own unit always forms the center of such cell. Three main components are combined in a single unit, a transponder. The transponder is fully automatic and should be kept in operation at all times, except where international agreements, rules, or standards provide for the protection of navigational information. The AIS transponder consists of a very high frequency, VHF, radio unit, global positioning system, GPS, receiver, computer, keyboard, and display unit. The GPS provides position and navigational data. The computer packs this information together with information about the vessel's speed, name, call sign, heading, course and speed over ground, etc. This information is transmitted at short intervals via VHF radio to other ships and or land-based stations within VHF radio range. If all ships within VHF range are equipped with AIS, the result is that everybody can see everybody. Fixed or static information is entered into the AIS during installation. This information need only be changed if the ship changes name or undergoes major conversion from one ship type to another. Dynamic information, which, apart from navigational status information, is automatically updated by the ship's sensors connected to AIS. Voyage-related information, which might need to be manually updated during the voyage. AIS information may be displayed as alphanumeric information and/or graphically on radar, ARPA, ECTIS, or other relevant systems. Present International Maritime Organization, IMO, AIS requirement allows display of AIS information as alphanumeric information only. This display is referred to as the minimum display. The minimum mandated display provides not less than 3 lines of data consisting of bearing, range, and name of selected ship. Other data about the ship can be displayed by the horizontal scrolling of data, but the scrolling of bearing and range is not possible. Vertical scrolling will show all other ships known to AIS. Instead of minimum keyboard display, MKD, most manufacturers provide what they call enhanced minimum keyboard display, which provides graphical presentation of AIS targets. Where AIS information is used with a graphical display, the following target options are available for display: sleeping target, activated target, selected target, dangerous target, and lost target. A sleeping target indicates only the presence of a vessel equipped with AIS in a certain location. No additional information is presented until activated, thus avoiding information overload. If the user wants to know more about a vessel's motion, he has to activate the sleeping target so that the display shows available target information. Available target information will be a speed vector showing calculated target speed and course over ground, target heading, rate of turn, ROT, indication, if available, to display actually initiated course changes. If the operator wants detailed information on a target, he may select it with a pointing device. Data received, as well as the calculated closest point of approach, CPA, and time to CPA, TCPA, values, will be shown in an alphanumeric window. The special navigation status will also be indicated in the alphanumeric data field, and not together with the target directly. If an AIS target is calculated to pass preset CPA and TCPA limits, it will be classified and displayed as a dangerous target, and an alarm will be given. At the time of production of this CBT, no international standards for AIS target symbols were established. IMO is currently working on the harmonization of ARPA, ECTIS, and AIS graphical target symbols. Performance standards for AIS were adopted in 1998. The regulation requires that AIS shall provide information, including the ship's identity, type, position, course, speed, navigational status, and other safety-related information automatically to appropriately equipped shore stations, other ships, and aircraft. Automatically receive such information from similarly equipped ships. Monitor and track ships, and exchange data with shore-based facilities.